everyone, assalamu alaikum. So today we are going to study about this thing right here. This is an IOPR film. So we are just going to open it up and see what contents are inside. And I hope this is my first and the last take of the video because I just have one IOPR. And I don't want to waste IOPRs, right? So we'll open it up and see what things are inside. So I'm just opening it up. Oh my god, it's not opening. Oh, okay. So as we open, we find this black thing here. Okay, I'll just take it out and see what else we have inside. I feel I'm opening a gift pack right now. So this is the lead paper. I think we call it the lead paper. And then we have, okay, I'll just go by sequence. So this is the lead paper. And then we have the black paper inside. And then we have this film. Oh my god, this is green. I always thought this is black in color. And then we have, once again, we have inside one more black paper. Okay, and this is the outer covering. And in the outer covering, I'm just trying to find out an embossed dot here. Where is the embossed dot, ma'am? Hey, where is the, this film doesn't have an embossed dot. Where is it, ma'am? Oh, I think this is it. I think this is it. It's very, you know, inconspicuous, if that's the word. Okay, just leave it for now. I will study what contents are inside. So this was our lead film. Then we had a black paper. Okay. Oops. Oh my god. And then we have this film. And then once again a black paper. So we have the lead film just on one side. And we'll see on what side we keep it, because this is associated with the formation of tire track appearance in the radiograph. So that means if you keep the film on the wrong way, the opposite way, what will happen is, process the film, you will find some as if, you know, a car went on your X-ray film, tire track appearance or herringbone pattern. Both are similar looking, so we named it so. I know I have messed up the video because I have taken so many breaks in between. Now please continue watching the rest of the video to find out the functions of these components. And this is my first appearance on a video ever. So I hope you like it. And if not, I hope you don't be very rude to me. And please don't forget to subscribe and comment. And see you, bye.
So this is how our X-ray film looks from inside. So this is the outer covering, which is waterproof. And then we have the lead foil. And then we have this black paper. And then we have this film. And then once again, we have a black paper. Okay, so as you can see, this film, it is in between these two black papers. So these black paper, what they do, so the black paper doesn't allow light leakage, because if the light leaks, it will expose the film and we won't get the image we want. And then the lead foil. So to explain the function of the lead foil, let me draw a teeth here. So this is our teeth and we have to radiograph this teeth. This is our tongue. So what we do, we place a film inside, okay? And let's suppose this is the lead foil, okay? Towards the tongue. So what will happen? So this is the X-ray machine. So the rays are coming from here and they will enter, and this lead film, what it will do, it will prevent the tongue and other oral tissues from these radiations, because this lead film will absorb the extra radiations. Okay, one more function is that it also prevents the backscatter. Okay, so if these radiations, they backscatter, what will happen? That will cause fogging of the film. Okay, now let's suppose you kept the film towards the wrong side. So I'll just remove all these things, and this is our tongue, and this is our film. And by mistake, I kept my film on the wrong side so that the lead foil is here now. So what will happen? These rays will again come. Okay. Now what will happen? As they reach the film, they first strike the lead foil. So this lead foil will absorb most of the radiation. So when you process such a film, you will find something which is called as the tire track appearance. Tire track appearance. Or we also call it the herringbone pattern. Herringbone pattern. Okay. So this is an error. We have to make sure that this lead foil, it is this side. Okay. And not this side. Alright. Now we are left with the film itself. So this is the film here. This is the film here. So this film, so it has a base, a subcoating, then we have emulsion, and then finally we have a supercoat. Let me draw a diagram here. So this is the base. This is the base. This base is made up of polyethylene terephthalate. Polyethylene terephthalate. Okay. And it is about 0.2 millimeters thick. It is 0.2 millimeters thick. Okay. Now we have a subcoating. So this subcoating, it is a thin adhesive material. So it is a adhesive material. Okay. So with the help of this adhesive material, we will stick the emulsion on the base. Now the emulsion, this is the emulsion. Now emulsion has two components. It has silver halide crystals, and then we have gelatin matrix. Now this silver halide crystal, it has silver bromide and silver iodide. It has silver bromide and silver iodide, and silver bromide is around 80 to 99%. Okay. And silver iodide is just 1 to 10%. So the function of silver iodide is to increase the sensitivity of the film. So it increases the sensitivity of the film. Okay, of the film. Also, we add some contaminants like the sulfur. So this also increases the sensitivity of the film. Okay, these silver halide crystals, these are photosensitive. Okay, so when they are exposed, they will react to it. They will respond to it. Now this gelatin matrix, it supports the halide crystals. So actually our halide crystals are suspended in the gelatin matrix. Okay, so this is in yellow. This is the gelatin matrix. Okay, and this is made up of, so this gelatin, it is made up from cattle bone, and it helps to keep the silver grains evenly dispersed. And also during processing, the gelatin absorbs the processing solution. So it absorbs the processing solution and helps to allow the chemicals to react with the halide crystals. Now finally we have this supercoat. So this is additional layer of gelatin. So it protects the film from any damage by mechanical handling. So here we had made a diagram. So here was our base, and then above it we will have a subcoating. Okay, and then we have this emulsion, and then again we have a supercoat. So this was the composition of an X-ray film. If you like the video, please give a thumbs up. See you in the next video. Allah Hafiz.